All right, so we're going to talk about flams. Flams is the first rudiment that you have, at least numerically in your list, that has a grace note attached to it. A grace note is a note that embellishes, in this case, a primary stroke or a tap. So I think of it kind of like wearing maybe a tie, or for ladies, maybe wearing earrings, or some type of outfit enhancer, right? It's not the main dress or suit or main body of clothing that you're wearing. It's something of an accessory, maybe, that enhances the outfit that you're wearing, okay? Could be like pinstripes down a car that makes it look extra fancy. But it's not the main thing. It just enhances that. Our grace notes, we always want to keep down. Much like you'll hear in our wind playing friends, where they will play this as a pickup. It's very, very close typically to the primary note, but the primary note sonically is way more important. So to play a flam, one of the things that I'm going to do is start my sticks at two very different heights. And I say very different because I want that grace note to be way down. It does not matter for our purposes right now what the dynamic is on the page. Your grace note will always be at the same height. So if you're dynamic is pianissimo, my grace note is way down. If it's at piano, it's at mezzo piano. If it's at mezzo forte, forte, fortissimo. If it was at 18 Fs, it would be up here, but my grace note would stay in pretty much the same place because it's not sonically important. Rhythmically, yes. One other thing that I'm going to mention here is this concept of playing open to closed. Many times when we hear this, especially if we're looking at audition repertoire or expectations, the requirements for auditions, it will say play your roles from open to closed, or play your flams from open to closed. And there's a little bit of, I think, some miscommunication or misunderstanding about this. Yes, open does mean, for example, that your grace note would be far away from your primary stroke. So, and closed would mean that that same grace note is closer to your primary stroke. But often, what open to closed is interpreted as is slow to fast, aka when you're playing your double stroke roll and you're playing an open to closed roll, you would typically play that slow to fast. So on and so forth. But with flams, what you actually want to do is play it from slow to fast, closed to open. Flams at a slow tempo shouldn't really be played open. Otherwise, they're sloppy. I'd rarely ever play that in a musical situation where we're playing a very slow tune and I play, because that's not considered a flam. It's so open. It's more like fa-lam. I really want that to be closed. It's slow, but it's closed. However, as I speed up my flams, believe it or not, I do actually open them up. It's not going to sound like they're very open because my flams are moving so fast, but I am opening my flams up. So flams played, let's say, at eighth notes at this tempo. I'm playing them open, meaning that I'm not trying to get them precisely together. That would be a unison, or too close, because that's going to be really difficult at that speed and almost impossible to gauge precisely how close they could be relative to this. So slow, fast, my flams sound consistent, but the performance of those is actually closed at a slow tempo to open at a faster tempo. All right, back to how to play flams now. We've mentioned keeping the grace note down. The grace note stroke is going to make an upstroke, meaning that it's going to play and come up. The primary stroke, or the main tap, is going to play a downstroke, meaning that it starts up and goes down and ends down. We are going to let it rebound slightly, but then we're going to stop it with our hand. If I simply push the stick into the head and grip it tightly, then the stick is going to want to rebound. You'll see it flail for a second in my hand. The tip of this kind of jerks around because it wants to rebound, and I'm not letting it. However, if I allow that to be relaxed for just a moment and then grip, squeeze a little bit with my fingers, then I'm not taking those vibrations into my hand and the stick's not flailing so much. So this is very different than this. That space is gone, there's tension there, and those vibrations are shooting up from the stick into my arm. If I'm playing on a hard surface or playing really loud or with a heavy stick, over time, that can really cause some issues here in my arm, whether it's just simple fatigue and lack of endurance or speed to really some issues with tendons or joints maybe later on, 5, 10 years, even 20 years down the road. So it is really important to stay as relaxed as possible. Yes, we'll need to squeeze on the stick a little bit, but we don't want to do too much with that. Okay, putting the hands together. If I play my primary strokes, first of all, with just a click, you know, and keep the quarter note there. If I set this to 80 beats a minute, and I just want to play quarter notes. That's what I want my hand to do when I'm playing flams. Now my left hand is actually going to play the same thing. Think about it like it's playing quarter notes. It's just a little bit before the click and it's playing super soft. You get the idea. Of course, I would do the same thing with my left hand. Make that the primary stroke, play some quarter notes there. Then take the right hand and try to place it just before the click. It is not uncommon when you're trying to get that grace note just before the click for that to be a little bit tricky. I get it that that's a timing issue, but I think it's important not to place that on the beat because you're training then your body to play this soft tap at the same time that you're going to try to put your primary stroke. And that's just not what we want. We don't want unison strokes, we want flams. The grace note has to happen before. And if I really program my body and my muscles to be thinking, this is where the click is, this is where the beat is, then that primary stroke is the one that's going to really take with the click, and mentally as well as physically. All right, from there, I'm ready to alter my hands or alternate my strokes. This is important because now, again, we're making downstrokes and upstrokes. When I'm playing it on the same hand, I'm making a full stroke. Both hands are actually making full strokes. My left stroke is full, it's just very low. If I'm playing my right hand, it also is a full stroke, but much higher. Notice that both sticks return to their starting position. I'm also not doing a prep motion. I don't need to set them here and then lift them up to play. This is definitely a common error and a bad habit that a lot of players have. They'll play, especially in soft dynamics, they'll put their sticks here and then raise them up. And you can see that it opened up my flams as well as my left hand. My grace note got a lot louder because it's actually playing from this height instead of down here. Instead of. Okay? So once I get those things down with the right flams, left flams, start to speed those up with the click and make sure that those are together and that I can feel those primary strokes with the click. Now I'm ready to go back slowly and start alternating my flams. So with the right hand up, the left stick down, I'm going to play one flam and I simply want to reverse the stick heights. I want it to be like a mirror image of what I see now. So I'm keeping my eye on where the stick height is because my left hand is going to come back up here. My left stick is going to rebound up here. My right is going to play down and end where my left stick is. So here we go. 2, 3, 4, 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. You'll notice that again, there's no prep or rebound. I'm not bringing anything up higher or rebounding higher than they end. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1. Now, You'll also notice that I'm not playing into the drum. Flams are not this. 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. You'll hear the sound difference. You'll see that my sticks both end down at the same height, which means I gotta pick one back up. And then most of the time, once I start to speed this up, when I pick one up, the other one will come up slightly. I usually play with both arms, and I'm already into my bad habit territory. So it's important not to be tight, but to be very precise about where your sticks end. 1, 2, 3, 4. Where does my primary stroke rebound to? Again, I'm keeping these pretty closed. So with that, I'll slowly start to speed that up. At faster tempos, I should get this down up a la push-pull motion from my hands. And essentially, it's like the strokes of a double stroke roll offset. If I were to take my left hand away, my right hand is playing. So you can see the downstroke, upstroke, downstroke, upstroke, and that push-pull kind of motion is in my right hand. Now you may say, well, the grace note is not as low as it was before. When I'm playing very quickly, then my grace note's got a rebound, or the first stroke has got a rebound naturally. I don't have time to do that squeeze and keep it super far down, but I am going to make sure that it's a light upstroke, so that that tap you can hear is quiet versus it's not two wrist strokes, it's an upstroke, which is quiet, a tap. Okay, so putting those together, quarters, eighths, and you'll see again that I try to end with my grace note down and my primary stroke up. So BPL level one, flams at a quarter note equals 125. And one and two and ready and.